Everybody, welcome to my channel. My name's Julie, if you're new here. Today we're going to do a home bargains haul. So I'm just going to, I've just finished getting ready. I'm just going to pop over to Home Bargains, do some filming in store, see if there's anything new in there, and then we will come back and I'll show you the haul. I just thought I'd show you my outfit of the day. So just let me turn the camera around. Okay, so today, excuse the mess on the bed. I've just got some brown wide leg trousers on, some tan sandals. These are Mashulu, and this is, you might have seen this in a previous haul, this is my white new look, like loose fit cotton top. It's not a bad day, it's about 18, 19 degrees and it's not raining at the moment. I've just put my bedding on the line, so I'm hoping that will dry. And yeah, I've got a cream coloured cardigan that I'm going to pop on with this. So yeah, that's my outfit for today. All my jewellery is my usual jewellery, my gold jewellery, vintage watch, my usual wedding rings, my bangles. This one is from, oh gosh, I can't remember, Abbott Lion, I think I've got one from, and the other one is, I'll pop it in the link below, I can't remember. These earrings are old. They're from, sorry, these earrings are old. They're from my mum. It's a pair of gold hoops. Yeah, so that's me. I will catch up with you when we get back. Bye for now.
No.
Hello.
I'm back from Home Bargains. I did pop in Aldi. I think I've got one thing from Aldi as well. So I thought I'd do a little haul for you while I'm now I'm back. Yeah, lots of you'll see from the footage I'm going to pop in before this. Lots of Halloween stuff, lots of pumpkin-y type stuff. Yeah, which all feels a bit early, really. But I know that they're always there just after summertime. So yeah, I didn't pick up anything like that, but I did get quite a few hair products. I got a skin product. What else? Yeah, stationery and some food products as well. So I'll do those first because they're the dull ones. I'm gluten free, and this is the bread I prefer. It's the Schar. I think it's a German brand. It's normally £3 a loaf in all of the major supermarkets. You occasionally get it for £2.75. But when I go into Home Bargains, I always have a look if they've got any of this, because it's exactly the same. It's just that the packaging is pared down. It freezes really well. And so I always get a few if I see them on offer. They're £1.51, I think they are, in Home Bargains. They're £3 in, as I said, all the other major supermarkets. So I got four of those, so that'll keep me going. I usually go through about one a week of these, so that'll keep me going for the next 4 weeks. So yeah, I thought that was a really good buy. Also, we buy our coffee from Home Bargains whenever we see it. I am not really a coffee drinker. Dave drinks coffee every day, all day. So breakfast, mid-morning, lunchtime, tea time, and a big mug of dark black strong coffee before he goes to bed at night, and he never has any problems at all sleeping. And he's very particular about his coffee, and this is his favourite. It's the Law Classy. They do an intense one as well, but he likes this one. And I think it's £7 in Tesco at the moment, and I've seen them for £8.50 as well in Morrison's, which I just think is dreadful to pay that much money for a jar of coffee. I just think it's terrible. Anyway, I don't care about the type of coffee. I mean, this is lovely, but I'd be quite happy with Aldi's own brand, or you know, any of the cheaper end. But Dave insists that we have this, and as it's his one luxury. So he doesn't have sugar or milk in either, so he can really taste the coffee. So he insists we have this. So I picked up three jars of these. They are £4.99 in Home Bargains, and as I said, they're always around £7, £8.50, unless you get them on special offer. You occasionally get a special offer at £5.25 or £5.50, so this is a really good price. So I've got three of those, so that'll keep us going for a while. I don't know, I've mentioned my brother's staying at the moment. He's over from Australia to visit us and my mum and dad. And so there's more of us in the house and more coffee drinkers, so we're whizzing through coffee at the moment, so I thought I'd pick up an extra few. I did get some other foodie items. Sorry, I'm bending out down here. I took them out of the bag so it wouldn't be rustling for you. What did I get? I picked up the gluten-free whipped bars. As I said, I'm gluten-free, so these are 80 calories each. I got the dark chocolate and coconut one, the salted caramel, which is my favourite one, and the lemon, white chocolate and lemon one. Yeah, 80 calories each, gluten-free, which I love, and they're just handy to have in. I'm trying to lose a bit of weight at the moment. I'm going to do a separate video about that, because there's loads to talk about and lots of history to talk about and things. So I thought I'd do if you've got any questions to ask me about that, pop them in the comments down below. But I'm going to do a video about my weight. I'm trying to lose a bit of weight purely because I have great difficulty with my knees. I've got arthritis in both knees, and I've had one knee replaced, and the other one is heading the same direction. And I went to see the consultant a few weeks ago, and he's loath to do another knee operation because I had such a lot of trouble with the one I've had done. The recovery period was horrendous, and it's not great. It's still a bit stiff. It wasn't a massive success, so really don't want to put myself through that again if I don't have to. And he suggested that I lose a bit of weight. It's just purely the amount of pressure on that joint. So not that I particularly want to lose weight. I mean, I'm very happy as I am, but I think for health reasons, I'm going to do it just to see if I can get away with not having this other knee done. And I'm fasting and just watching what I eat generally, but I will go into lots more detail for you if you're interested in a weight loss video. So yeah, pick those up just to have as a snack before I start my fast, which is normally about 7 o'clock. So I will put those in my snack cupboard. Okay, what else did I get? I got some stationery. I picked up this they were 99p if I didn't say. This Bright Ideas, I think it was 150 this. This is my YouTube book. I've been writing ideas for videos down and what I want to do and what I want to tell you on bits of paper here, there and everywhere. So I wanted a dedicated book just to sort of keep my ideas for videos, different hauls I want to do and things I want to talk to you about. So I'm going to start using this, so I've got everything in one place. So it's just, I like a spine like this. I don't like a book that you've got to try and fold flat, and they're just nice big large lined. I think it's an A4 size, this. I do like the stationery in home bargains, it's such a reasonable price. So I'll pop that in my basket. I also picked up a card for we went away this weekend to Stratford to see some family down there, and they always make us extremely welcome. They're lovely, and we always really enjoy it. And I wanted to just send a thank you card across, so I just picked up this one. They didn't have a thank you card, but this is just a blank card. I thought it was pretty. I like the foil flowers on it. So yeah, hope you can see that. It's not too, well, that's better. Yeah, so I pop that one in my basket. I'm gonna send that off tomorrow, I think. So everything else is toiletries. So I have a bath every night. It's got to be very, very warm for me not to have a bath. One, because I enjoy it and it's relaxing and it's just me time. Nobody can ask me to do anything or go anywhere. I can just chill. But one of the other reasons is the warmth of the water really helps my joints. So I like to, I can really feel it if I don't have a bath and I get in bed at night. I have much worse night's sleep if I can have a bath. You know, if I have a bath, it really helps. So I thought I'd try this one. Not seen this before. It's a mineral bubble bath, and it's cherry blossom, relaxing and pampering from the Dead Sea collection, with natural Dead Sea minerals and cherry oil. It's quite a big one. This, it's 1,000 mils. I think it's £2.99. This one. Is it a cap or is it a twist? Yeah, it's a twisty one. It smells divine. I wish we had smell vision. It smells very strong cherry, kind of cherry Batewell flavour smell. I don't know whether it's coloured or... No, it just looks like a milky colour. But yes, I thought I'd pop that one on the side of the bath and try that as a treat. I've never tried the Dead Sea collection, so I guess it's a home bargains thing. But so I got that one, that'll last me a while, although I do whiz through it. Then I got, as you can see, I've got curls in my hair today, and I've been watching lots of videos trying to learn how to put curls in that will stay in for more than a day with straighteners. I've tried a wand that didn't work. I really struggled with it. I don't like the ones with a clip on. I also struggled with that, and I do manage to get a curl into my hair, although you can see it's dropping out as we speak. I do manage to get a bit of a wave, and I actually don't want a curly curl. I just want a wave. This morning, I split it into three sections, and as I curled it, I sprayed hairspray onto the bit that was just done as it was cooling, which was a tip that I saw on a video on YouTube. And that seems to have kept them in a little bit better. But one of the things that she did use was a texturising spray. So I picked one up in Home Bargains, and this one was, I think it was £1.99. It's the Got To Be, which I have used this range before and I like it. I think it's Schwarzkopf, and it's a beach matte texturising salt spray. So I thought next time I curl my hair, I might just give that a try and see if it holds things in place better, because she did use that. Also, while I was there, I picked up a dry shampoo, and I've not tried the Got To Be shampoo range, extra volume dry shampoo. Well, I always want extra volume, so I normally do the Batiste, but I thought I would give this one a try. So I picked that one up. Yeah, as I've told you before, I'm growing out my natural colour. I was growing out my natural colour, and I must say I don't like it. If you know me, you know that I change my mind about my hair a lot. I've had lots of different styles. I have it very short, then I have it long. This mid-range length suits me because I can have it in a style, or I can put it back, which I don't like it so short that I can't get it back if I just want to pop it out of my way for the day. So yeah, but I'm just not loving the colour. It feels super dark. So I mentioned it to my daughter-in-law at the weekend, and she recommended a lady from Instagram that she's going to see, who's a colour specialist, and she sort will do a consultation, and then you go back and she'll gradually put colour in your hair, but exactly what you want. You know, she really listens to what you want. I often find when I have colour put in at the hairdressers that they tell them what I want. So I always want it ashy. I want it blonde, ashy, but easier to maintain. Something that's not going to go orange or red or brassy. And I never end up with that. I always end up with more of a warmth. And I think that's probably because my natural hair maybe pulls slightly warm. So I'm going to see this lady at the end of August, and hopefully she will change things for me. So I'd really like some nice, fine, ashy highlights to it, just to give everything a lift. I feel like it lifts my face when my hair's a little bit lighter. And I know my thinking was of growing it out was that it would be easy maintenance. I wouldn't have to think about it. I'm lucky that I don't have very much grey at all. And so I thought, I just won't have to worry about it. I can just get it cut. But actually, I don't like it. So I drive my husband mad. I really do. So that's why I'm on here talking to you about it. So yeah, as you can see, it's like a very dark blonde. But yeah, I definitely need to lift it up. So that's what I'm going to do. So I'm practicing the styles that I'm going to have it when I've got my new colour in. Well, for now, and when I've got my new colour in. But yeah, the colour's the next thing. So watch this space. I'll kind of document that if you're interested in me doing that. Okay, the next thing I got was just a shower cream body wash. It's the Dove Nourishing Silk one. I've not had this one before, but I think it's M. I think Emma mentioned this on her channel and said how lovely this was and how nice it smelled. I really struggle with body washes. I only use them when I'm in the shower, so I tend to shower in the morning and have a bath in the evening. And whatever I get, I always think, it's all right, but nothing fantastic. But this does smell really nice and clean. So see how I go on with that one. So yeah, that I think that was just 99p, the little Dove. I didn't give you the prices of everything, did I? This one, the dry shampoo was £1.49, I think, and the Got To Be Beach Mat was £1.99. So yeah, that was my haul from Home Bargains. And then we just, right next door to the Home Bargains near us is a Aldi and a TK Maxx. And I did go in TK Maxx, but I'm going to film that as a separate haul because I've got quite a bit of stuff and I want to go into detail, so that will be coming up soon. I've also got a next haul coming up soon, done quite a big next haul. So yeah, the next video, after this video, I think it's going to be my next haul, and then the TK Maxx video will be next week. But while I was at Aldi, I just popped in to see if they had any of the makeup or skincare dupes, and I needed one of these. So this is the Lacura Healthy Glow Glycolic Toner. So I picked this up. I've been using this for years and I really, really like it. I really rate it. And I'm down to the last kind of tiny bit in my bottle. So I think I had about 3 or 4. So they just had one of these, so I picked it up. So that'll last me a good couple of months. Yeah, I use this in the morning. So I usually wash my face just with water. And then when I've got my contact lens in, I use that on a cotton pad, just to, it sort of freshens everything up. I feel like it sort of brings my face awake in the morning. So I picked that one up. I've just realised that I've forgotten a couple of things from B&M, so I'll pop these on the end. So this is just the saline solution for my contact lenses, and I do like the sensitive eyes one. And this comes, it's a nice big bottle, and it comes with a little pot. Oh, I thought it did. Maybe not. Anyway, I picked up this, which is the Optivive Sterile Saline Solution for Sensitive Eyes, and just to wash my contact lens at the end of the day. I think I've got an extra pot somewhere. I need to find that. So yeah, picked that one up. That was £1.99, and lasses me, I don't know, 12 months, 2 years, a long time, a long time. And finally, I have a new cleaner for the bathroom. This is the Dettol multi-purpose cleaner, and it's a flower power one. I've not tried this one before. Again, this was £1.99. I don't know about you, but I have separate cleaning products for my upstairs bathroom and for the downstairs of the house. So in the bathroom, the big bathroom up here, I have a little like a caddy, and I keep a set of cleaning products up there, so that on usually on a Saturday morning when I clean the bathroom, I can just come upstairs and everything's there that I need. Cloths and anything that I need is in there, the bleach and stuff. So this is just to replace the one. I think I had the pink stuff in there before. So this is just to pop in instead of that one, because that one's empty. So I picked that up as well. So yeah, that's my Home Bargains haul. Let me know if you've been to Home Bargains recently, if you've seen anything exciting. I was with other people when I went. I was with my mum and dad and my brother. So it's not as easy to sort of really take your time and look at every single product, but they did have some interesting stuff in. So yeah, and the Home Bargains near us is a nice big one, which I think is always good as well. So yeah, that's my haul for today. As I said before, let me know if you're interested in a video on weight loss, because I'm happy to talk about that. And I will be back with you in a couple of days with my next video. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.